I'm not gonna fight back what I've become. Yeah, I got bruises where I came from.
1, 2, 3. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this interview with the one, the only, Maximillian. Hi, Max. So we're gonna be doing two segments real quick with you, bud. So first part, we're gonna play a little game. Second part, we're gonna dive into some actual proper questions, all right? You ready to go?
Yeah.
So these are your song titles translated to our local language. You gotta hear it, feel it, and your song title will be there. Number one, Lebih Tinggi. Tinggi. Lebih.
I'm looking at you.
the gestures are supposed to help, you know? Lebih. Yes, correct, higher. Okay, I gave the body language to help
you.
Yeah,
that's the body language helping.
It's gonna get harder. Next one, perasaan. When you left me alone at prom, Max, my perasaan was really hurt.
Feelings?
Yes, correct, feelings. Hari kosong. Kosong directly means empty, by the way.
Oh,
it's two words. It's two words. It's two words. It's a beautiful hari. No. All right.
Holidays?
Correct. Yes, holiday. All right, next one. All right, this one's a three-worder. I'm not going to give you a hint. I think it's too easy. Cinta macam ini.
I know better.
No, you're very close. Love like this. I'm gonna take this as a wrong. Cinta macam ini, Max. All right, the last one. You kind of said it earlier, but I'm gonna just give it to you anyways. Saya tahu lebih baik.
Is it I know better?
Yes, it is. I know better. I think by sheer length of the title, you got this right. Have you been to Malaysia before, and what do you know about us?
I haven't been to Malaysia. I have a friend who's been talking about Malaysia. He's been a few times. He says it's incredible. He actually promised me, he promised he'd take me one day.
The Beautiful Scars music video has 50 million views on YouTube at this very moment. What can you tell us about the aesthetic? I think you've spoken many times about the meaning of the song, but about the aesthetic of it, the flower field, the yellow, how it looks, it's so, for the lack of a word, beautiful.
We're talking about the fact that Beautiful Scars is quite a dark topic. So we wanted to like kind of twist it to the meaning of the song. That's like seeing the beauty in it, you know, in it all. And we just wanted to like maybe portray it as like a love story. You know, it's not a love song, which is strange, because when you look at the video, you get the kind of feeling that it is. But I think we really nailed the aesthetic looking part, and we went down to the beach at the end of the video, and we were having them standing in the ocean with like the waves coming, and it was just, everything just looks so amazing. I'm really proud of it.
Letters is about friendship and the struggle to keep it, you know, through the changes and the normalities of life. Did you struggle with that a lot through the pandemic?
I wrote this song to my best friend, who is not around at the moment. Started thinking about the fact that how often do I even tell the people around me that I love them and how much they mean to me. And I felt ashamed in a way, because I know that I hadn't been that great at telling even my family that how much they mean to me. I think it's really important that we always keep reminding ourselves and the people around us. One day, they might not be there anymore.
So much closer to the release of your debut album, Too Young. Can you tell us a little bit about it? What was the inspiration behind like Too Young as an album?
When you were a kid, did you ever get told that you were just too young to know something? You're like, you're too young, just get over it.
Exactly, like, right? Do it and you can't just...
People tell us that we should just get over something when that feeling still feels the same way. So this album is like a lot of different stories, most for the most part in relationships, but also these personal songs where letters is a part of it. And the first song of the album is also a song I wrote to my friend. And that's like the more inner personal aspect of it.
What might Maximillian be singing about 5 years from now?
I mean, I'm always going to be writing about my personal experiences. If I start writing about stuff that doesn't really mean anything to me, it's just going to be not good. I'll just keep experiencing things and I'll just write about that.
The plan is to keep living. The plan is to keep living. For those of you who have never heard of Maximillian, ever, what is the one song out of your entire catalog that you would recommend them that truly embodies you as an artist?
I'd actually say Ripples. It's got a darkness all, with also having, you know, like a positive note to it. I dig all my songs. You know, I think you should, as an artist, you should be able to love and listen to your own music because you made it because you like it.
That's a fair point. You should be able to listen to your own music and like it. Lastly, Maximillian, we need a message. What would you like to say to your lovely, dedicated fans here in Malaysia?
I want to say thank you all so much for being so nice to me. Can't wait for all of you guys to hear this album. Love how you all took in Letters and Love Like This. And, these new songs are going to be in some way in the same camp, but it's also some new things I'm trying out, so I hope you like it. I really hope you can connect with it. And I just, love y'all. It's gonna be dope. I'm Maximillian and you're watching World of Buzz.